Hello everyone, and welcome to this session. And in this session, we have two speakers, Pratik and Mohit, and they'll be talking on how to create personalized chatbots using Motic. And it's a very interesting section. A little bit about Pratik. Pratik is the director of consulting services and Aqua services at AxelerRent, where he helps accelerate digital outcomes for customers that deliver great digital experiences utilizing open source technologies. And Pratik works with organizations, brands, startups, and agencies to distill product requirements and define product roadmap based on their strategic goals. He's a software development leader with over a decade of experience in development, testing, products management across a variety of businesses and process domains. So welcome, Pratik, our first speaker. And our second speaker is Mohit. Mohit is going to be talking alongside Pratik. Mohit is working as a technical architect at AxelerRent. He's also an open source enthusiast, and he has been working with Drupal, Motic, and other PHP frameworks. He's also an active contributor to various open source projects like Motic and Drupal. He's a frequent speaker at various Drupal events across around the globe. And apart from PHP ecosystem, he's actively keeping and exploring new technologies like GraphQL and other exciting JS frameworks. So I'll be giving them the room to speak. They'll be talking on how to create personalized chatbots using Motic. So welcome our two speakers, Pratik and Mohit.
Thank you so much, Shivet. Thank you for the warm introduction. I just want to make sure my screen is visible before I get started.
All right. I'm seeing you perfectly. Okay.
Yeah, so are you able to see my screen as well? It just doesn't appear for me. Oh, okay, I think it's... All right. I can see the screen now. Thank you. Thank you everyone for joining the session, and a warm welcome to Moticon 2020. We are really excited to be here and really looking forward to this event and the amazing Motic work, and learn about the amazing Motic work that you all have been doing. Favor already did a brief introduction of ourselves. These are our contact information. I'm Pratik, Director and Consulting Services at AxelerRent. These are my contact details in case you want to reach out to. And I have Mohit, who is a technical architect. And both of our details are over here. Before we get started about this session, I just want to give you a quick overview about the AxelerRent, the organization that we work with. We are a value-driven agency with a work culture that fuels success through open source software, focusing on employee happiness, engineering excellence, and customer success. We are a fully distributed team of 120 professionals checking in from all over India and having a presence in six different time zones. We are also a globally recognized and a community-driven leader in open source web development. And we have been working with technologies like Drupal and Motic for a long time, along with other open source technologies. And we are also a frequent contributor to different community initiatives. Before I talk about chatbots and Motic, right, I want to just kind of do a quick recap of different industrial revolutions that have happened. So the first industrial revolution was when a steam engine became fuel efficient, and then hand production methods, we moved from hand production methods to machines. In the second industrial revolution, which is also known as technological revolution, electricity came in, we had telephones, light bulbs, and that helped enable rapid industrialization. Post that, in the third industrial revolution in 1900s, the computing came in, and there was a shift from mechanical to analog to digital electronics. The existence of personal computers, internet, information and communication technologies were evolved during this period. And today we are in the fourth industrial revolution, which is about intelligence. And there is a reason I call it as an intelligence, because the things like robotics, artificial intelligence, nanotechnologies, quantum computing, IoT, maybe 3D printing, autonomous vehicle, right? All of them are not only becoming efficient, but are becoming intelligent as well, and helping us across different things and different domains. And through this industrial revolution, the digital engagement has become really, really important. How your consumers and users engage with your products. And if I have to describe what is digital engagement, it is anything and everything that involves a conversation online to provide a great customer experience. It refers to anything that involves an online interaction. Specifically, it includes four key elements, things like use of digital tools to find, listen, and to interact with our brands, consumers, around a range of products. Also, we have been engaging, traditionally we have been engaging, or we have been engaging with customers from different platforms, like such as being SMS or in-app messaging, being one of those, through websites and on web, there could be self-service communities, portals, live agent, web chat, and these are the different ways we have been communicating with the customers. And lastly, social media, where you have Twitter, Facebook, and other social media tools platforms that everyone is accessing and connecting with your customers, or you are connecting, or brands are connecting with the customers. But at the same time, even though there are multiple channels and over here, right? I mean, a multi-channel approach to market and sell and to serve customers enables brands to switch users or switch customers between channels without interrupting the engagement to create a unified customer experience. Now, even though there's this unified experience through these different platforms, there are some limitations, and businesses still fail to provide an engaging customer experience. And that is primarily because there is accessibility issues and slow onboarding. According to a study, on an average, it takes about 7 minutes until any human is assigned to a person when you call on a customer care phone number, or you are interacting with via a chatbot or voice assistant as well. And secondly, because traditionally these interactions were about humans, and humans can only communicate with one human at a time, there was a low handling capacity as well. And this led to unsatisfied customers because you may not get all the answers. Sometimes it becomes difficult to access the past history. Customers have to repeat when they are communicating with your brand through these different platforms. And navigation challenges, again, through IVR, it becomes frustrating at times to navigate through website as well as to reach to the support page itself. And nonetheless, because of this experience, it's boring and time consuming. It does not engage your customers. It's not personal enough. It gives unnecessary information, and users have to look for what's relevant to them rather than they being presented automatically by the system what may be relevant to those users. And therefore, with these, there are a few emerging trends when we talk about the digital engagement, and there are three different key parameters to it. One is real time, second is connected, and third is personalized. People are growing impatient with the notion of waiting, and companies are being challenged to foster a real-time two-way dialogue with customers. And 74% of the customers expect companies to interact with them in the real time. Nearly 80% of the customers expect consistency when interacting across multiple departments. In short, effective engagement also needs to be connected, meaning, for example, that anyone at a company can quickly look up the customer information and easily use it to engage them accordingly, without peppering them with questions again and again. The best companies engage with their customers on the channel or device that the customer prefers, and not what is most convenient for the companies, whether that's online, over the phone, via a smartphone app, or even a voice assistant. Customer expects service to know about them, their needs, and use that information to help them, irrespective of the way customer is interacting with the brand. Lastly, most customers, or rather 73% of the customer, now expect companies to understand their needs and expectation. And that is through personalization. And personalization, while already recognized by marketers as having a big impact across the customer journey, is a given. Customers want a tailored experience as they progress from first hearing that a company exists all the way through to deciding to buy from them. For example, from seeing your ad on the side of the bus all the way through clicking a buy button on your e-commerce site as well. They also want these tailored experience coupled with engagement from customer service. And that is where chatbots come in. There are a lot of things, a lot of benefits when we talk about chatbots. One, they are accessible anytime, and they are not dependent on the humans. You can set it up and as an organization, as a brand, and forget about it. They are scalable. Bots can serve multiple customers at a time. You don't have to worry about the limitation of one-on-one human interaction. And because it's a bot, they remember you. They remember the user preferences and history. I mean, example, your food order, your preferences, your address, and that enables faster onboarding. And it leads to work automation, and it automates the mundane task like asking for the address, which is kind of goes away the boring aspect of onboarding any customer or interacting with any customer. And post that, it's proactive and predictable. It suggests and highlights information, and they can predict the responses as well. And it's cost effective because one application can take care of support of thousands of customers, efficient in collecting information. You can reuse that information and present it back to the customer in a meaningful manner. Now, so when you talk about these chatbots, right, I mean, there are also some limitations around it. But then before we talk about personalized chatbots, I wanted to talk about a little bit about the Motic and personalization. Motic has traditionally allowed dynamic customization in the form of email, forms, and landing pages for specific customer segments or a group of leads or a prospect. You can create a segment and based on it, you can kind of send out the personalized emails. But then there's still a limitation to it because these are not one-to-one personalization. And therefore, for one of our projects, there was a need where we wanted to personalize information and things for our customers and do it in one-to-one manner. Today, customer experience is not a nice to have or only something that you focus on post sales, but then it has to be through the journey of customer getting on your platform and then from there up until the end. And this in turn fuels your revenue. And thinking holistically while defining the customer journey, you have to have a personalization. Even though our client was doing all these personalization that Motic offers, but then they were missing this one-on-one personalized experience for their customers. And hence we came up with an idea to have a chatbot which can be personalized. And we enabled using this chatbot in Motic, all customer contact information was kind of stored in a Motic, and we integrated that with a Drift chatbot. And this is what we are going to show you next. So I'm going to quickly walk you through what we did through a demo. I'm not showcasing you the entire bot itself, but then a concept or how we did it. Anybody who is willing or want to make these one-on-one personalized chatbots, you can do that. So diving into it, this is a simple form. This is just a demo website, as I said, which kind of you can think of it as your lead generation form. And when you load this page, this is integrated with the Drift chatbot over here. As you can see the message, right, it's pretty generic over here. It just does not say anything about the customer. So when you talk about, hello there, I trust you're staying safe in this trying time, how can I help you, right? Even though this is good, we wanted to make this welcome message personalized. And in order to do that, what we did is that, I mean, as soon as Motic knows who that customer is, like, for example, I'm going to fill in this Motic form over here. So I'm just entering my information over here, and I submit it. Now, we have integrated Motic over here. I'm going to show it to you. I mean, it will create a contact in the Motic. As soon as I do this, I can go into my Motic backend system. And I should see a contact being generated over here when I reload this page. I'll just give it a second. Okay, it logged me out. I'm logging back in, and as you can see, Motic has identified me as a as a lead or as a contact now. Now, as soon as the Motic does it, and when I go back to the chatbot, and let's say I come back or browse the website and go to a different pages, you would see a personalized message from the chatbot now. I might have to do a couple of times a hard refresh to kind of load the data, but then once the Motic recognizes, I'm able to pass that information from Motic to the chatbot. So as you can see, right, I mean, now I'm seeing a personalized message where it says, hello, Prateek, instead of just saying a generic name or hello there. And it also shares or shows my city where I come from. Now, the idea over here is that you would be able to pass any information that you possess about the customer, be it their companies, be it any field that exists in the Motic, and you will be able to pass it to the Drift chatbot or any other chatbot. And post that, you will be able to customize your chatbot and the playbook, right, from based on it. And this way we kind of integrate it. So I'm going to quickly show it to you how we did this as well. So now that this is personalized over here, I'll go back to our Drift. So we use the Drift, and the Drift allows us to put personalization tokens over here. So what we did is, as a welcome message, I kind of added few tokens over here. And like you can see over here, I will try to add, let's say, a city. So city, if I enter, let's say, what would be the default value, whatever default value I want to provide over here, and I can insert it. Now, you can customize and build your playbooks in Drift chatbot or any other chatbot like this. Most of these chatbot platforms provide a way to pass on this information through APIs. Drift had an easy way where you have these personalization token, and this kind of helped us to do it. So we created this playbook, used these tokens available over here, and to customize our playbook. And then the next step was to pass on this information from Motic to Drift chatbot. And that is what we are going to talk about the next, how programmatically we passed on that information. I will hand it over to Mohit to talk a little bit more about that in detail.
Can you confirm, Prateek, like if you can hear me?
Yes, Mohit, I can hear you. Okay.
All right, yeah, thanks. So thanks everyone for joining today. And so we'll be actually going through like how we like created a plugin, like what are the things that are needed to build a plugin. And we'll go through like about a few events that we leveraged while while passing data from Motic to Drift. So this is about like basic scaffolding of the Motic plugin actually. So we have like integrations bundle that provides like various options to store like Drift related information, like client and secret and all sort of things. Apart from that, it also provides like various models where we can configure about let's say how data should be mapped and all those things.
Mohit, I'm sorry, I cannot hear you either. I'm not sure if it's just me. Favor, if you are there, can you please confirm if you can hear Mohit? I'm unable to hear you. Yeah, now I can hear you.
So the like overall gist is that like first we will like provide all sort of configuration about like what we want to inject into into Drift Jet application. And once we have all sort of configuration, what we need to do is like when Motic is tracking that particular lead or particular contact, we will inject all sort of things into into basically Drift.js. So yeah, I mean, we go to next slide, Pratik. Yeah. So this is like, as Pratik mentioned, right? So it is about basically the configuring how we can actually configure the things in. I think Pratik, probably something got changed, I guess. Yeah.
I'm not sure. I think
slide, so. Yeah. Yep.
Okay. Yeah. They're back.
Yeah. Correct. Yeah. So yeah. So this is about basically how we can, you know, personalize the Drift chatbot. There are few configurations that are needed on the Drift side. Like for example, we need to provide, we need one webhook URL, which is like Drift will hit to that webhook on the Motic, and it will like push all the information to Motic side, so that like Motic has also idea about like all the contact and relevant information. So this is about like setting up Drift application. Apart from that, like as like Pratik mentioned, right, we can actually configure like entire personalized message, so that like so we can greet accordingly. So yeah, this is about configuring Drift applications. Moving on to next one, Pratik. Yeah. So as I mentioned, right, so to implement the personalization, Drift has an API basically. So like Drift has a basically JS method called Drift.identify. So what we need to do is we need to pass all sort of contact related attributes into Drift.identify method. So to build that, actually, what we need to do is like we need to attempt it in two phases, actually. First of all, we need to like get the contact which is being tracked, actually. So the like current contact in the current context. So once we have that contact, once we have that contact data, what we need to do is we need to find like all the fields from that contact that we want to inject into Drift. So once we have that data, what we do is like we store the data into one variable, and after that, like we have another event actually on build.js. So on build.js, basically it's like another event actually build motic.js. So this JS is basically another like we can say event subscriber. So what it does is it allows us to, you know, modify the Motic core tracking JS, which is like mtc.js, which like you might be aware of, right? So it allows us to, you know, add our additional customized JS in mtc.js. So the like the two steps are there. First, identify the contact. Second is like with the contact detail, customize and add our custom JS into like mtc.js, so that like it should have idea about like how things are. So yeah, let's see like how we can actually let's go to next slide, Pratik. So this is method basically what happens like on contact track method, right? So what we are actually doing is like we get the recent contact based on event actually. So like Motic will like by the time this is being called, Motic will have like already identified the user, or we can say lead. So what we do is like we get the configurations from the plugin configuration about like what all fields that we want to, you know, inject into our mtc.js. So once we have that like all the field data in identity map, we just set one variable. We say like let's say drift underscore contact, and store all sort of variable out there in that and that like drift underscore contact data. So so that like in the next step, when we are building things in mtc.js, we will read it from there. So yeah, let's see the next one. Yeah. So basically this is our method, on build.js method. So what happens actually, we have like added another like event listener function, JS function. So the thing is that like once we have the response and once we have the data, if you can see on line 42, we are checking like if we have the data in the drift underscore contact, right? So once we have the data, let's say for now, we are like passing all the attributes, like let's say email and all other contact related data. So basically, we need to include like Drift.js as well, and Drift.identify is like method in Drift.js. So what it does is basically we need to pass a couple of attributes, like for example, email and Drift contact will have all of the data which Drift needs actually. So you can refer Drift API for that. So it will be like in the key value pair of like, you know, first name, last name, CT or whatsoever. So this will be the like variable, which is like all sort of data. And email is something which, you know, Drift uses to, you know, uniquely identify the particular user. So once we have the all sort of data, we just pass it into like drift.identify method. And yeah, and Drift will eventually will take care of it, like the personalizing message and all those things. And yeah, in the last like row 50, yeah, we just pass it to like the, we just pass like entire JS variable into, mtc.js. So like once this is done, I mean, if you open the mtc.js, we will have this code injected into our JS file. And yeah, and like as we all know, right, we have a like Drift bot on that page. So yeah, Drift's JS file will already be there. And yeah, drift.identify will get invoked from here. So it will actually personalize the message that, you know, we have configured in the Drift backend. So yeah, that's pretty much about like the all the mechanism of how we actually get the data and pass the data into Drift. So yeah, next one, Pratik. Yeah. So yeah, I mean, we already saw the demo for this. So yeah, I mean, that's pretty much it from a technical perspective. Moving to you, Pratik. Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you, Mohit. Moving on, right? I mean, like, so as Mohit described, right? I mean, we inject this data on the web page. I mean, we can directly do an inspect element over here. For example, we'll just try to see what exists within it. I'll quickly show you the mtc.js. As you can see, I mean, this is the file which is there for Motic and tracking the events. It has a function over here, which is we added this event listener and then called this function drift.identify. And this is the function which, after getting injected from mtc2.js, tells to Drift that this is the data that needs to be known. So this is how we have passed the information or the context information from Motic to Drift. And you can typically pass on this information in to any other any other platform as well, not just chatbots. It's just a way to inject this JavaScript into the primary mtc.js to be able to utilize that information and use it for any purpose that you may want. And for us, we use it for this to build this chatbot. Moving on, we want to talk a little bit also about and kind of conclude it in the end to talk a little bit about how do you build these chatbots. Broadly, Drift is one way to do it, but then there are different ways and different chatbots being available. I mean, be it and different NLP and NLU engines that exist that you can use to build these chatbots. But at the same time, while designing this chatbots, it's important to understand what your chatbot does. And a lot of times, the chatbots are designed in a manner which are not user friendly, and it just probably either throws or doesn't throw any information or throws a lot of information. And therefore, it's important that you keep few parameters in mind while designing any chatbot. And we also wanted to introduce a term, conversational framework or conversation marketing, which is kind of a fastest way to move buyers through your marketing and sales funnels through a power of real-time conversation. It builds relationship and creates authentic and delightful experience for your customers and buyers. And in order to create that delightful experience, your chatbot needs to do and make sure they kind of adhere to these, you keep track of these four parameters that we are going to talk about, four-step process. You need to make sure while designing your chatbot, you engage user, and you engage them by being personalized, by being very targeted and showing them the personalized message. So this is what would engage the users. We need to better understand what you offer as a company, as an organization, or as a brand. And what you offer to the customer, how and how it will solve their needs. So in this example over here, we need to understand the user Mike lives in the New York City. He buys dress shirts and jeans. And therefore, it needs to, based on that information, we need to personalize it. And a lot of this information at times is not just within the MarTech as a marketing automation tool, but it's there in your CDPs as well. In a similar fashion, that information can be linked and provided to your chatbot client, and so that the entire omni-channel experience to engage the customer and providing those delightful experiences can be made. So it's very important you understand your customers and the users. And then based on the inputs, based on the understanding and based on the data, you recommend the next steps. Customers who want honest and helpful recommendation, recommendations at times could be about as simple as scheduling or kind of guiding them to a sales assistant or anything else. So it has to end in a fashion where it is a smooth transition from a bot to a sales assistant if it's needed, or whatever the other next steps that are recommended through your workflow or through your chatbot playbook. And lastly, but nonetheless, I mean, you have to repeat it. I mean, doing this chatbot, doing this engage, understand, and recommend is not straightforward at times. It takes time to learn and relearn the things. And by getting the feedback from the users to improve the conversation flow and utilizing your data to make these decisions is very, very important while designing any chatbot solution. So we wanted to kind of end with this, end our session with this, but we wanted to also highlight one other thing that we have not touched upon. How did we build the entire plugin from scratch? How did we start it and all? And there's another session by both Mohit and me about MarTech plugin development using integration framework at 12 p.m. UTC on the same track number 5. And that is where we will be talking in detail. It will not be about the Drift and the chatbot, but then the plugin development part of the things would be covered over here, how we leverage these integration frameworks. So the same can be applied where sharing the information from Drift to MarTech and MarTech to Drift or any other platform. We would be, how do you integrate and sync data between any third-party systems in MarTech? How do we set up new plugins that can leverage integration framework, be it managing plugin data using synchronization-related configuration, authentication part of the system, and also listening to the web hooks that Mohit touched upon briefly, and also managing the data storage in MarTech. So we will be deep diving into it, all the code through it in this session, which is there at 12 p.m. UTC time. With that, we would like to conclude our sessions and hoping that it was helpful. Feel free to reach out to both Mohit and me for any questions throughout the event. We would be available. And also, if you have any questions right now, please share it so that we can help answer it. Thank you. Okay, we cannot hear you.
Thanks a lot, Patrick and Mohit. We have a few questions from the audience, and I'll be sharing my screen now. Okay, so just give me a second.
Okay. I think you're on mute again.
You guys will answer the questions that the audience have put out. So I'll leave the stage for the both of you now.
Okay. I guess. The first question is, the example in the demo was built using Drift. Are there other alternatives that can be used to build a personalized chatbot? That's definitely possible. I mean, we just happened to use Drift because our customer was already using the Drift chatbots, but then We can use any other chatbot. I mean, we have used things like Microsoft Bot Framework, Dialogflow, and others as well. And all of these chatbots provides the APIs, which lets you communicate with them and then communicate back the information from chatbots to your MOTIC system or any other CDPs that you may have. So that's definitely possible to use other options, other thing, anything else apart from Drift. Mohit, would you like to take the second one? Is there a way to pass the information from Drift to MOTIC as well?
Yeah, sure. So basically what happens in Drift, like if we go to like Drift backend, it has a configuration to add the like webhook URLs. So what we need to do like is like we create one webhook on the MOTIC side. We can use like existing one as well. It depends on the requirement. So yeah, so we create one webhook on the like MOTIC plugin and add that webhook URL on the Drift configuration. So what happens like at the time like certain event happens, Drift will like send a request to that webhook and and from that like webhook request we can like get the relevant data like creating contact or like adding points or like do whatever processing that we want to do with the like webhook payload. So yeah, there is a way to pass data from Drift to MOTIC. Yeah.
Great.
The second question has to be answered too. So is there a way to pass information from Drift to MOTIC as well?
Yeah, we just did that. So yeah, it's possible to pass on that information as Mohit described.
All right. So I guess that's all for this session. Thank you again, Pratik and Mohit, for taking out the time to speak. And I'm sure our audience have gotten know how to create personalized chatbots using MOTIC. A lot for the time, and the session was very well full of information, and I enjoyed the session very well. Hoping to see you by 1 p.m. my time for the next session. Have a nice day.
Thank you,
thank you, everyone. Thank you. Yeah, thank you, everyone. Bye. Thanks for joining today. Bye.
Thank you, everyone.